Changing the world, one nanometer at a time, is the slogan you get when you log on to the homepage of ASML. ASML bets they are probably a part of the electronic device you're using right now. That's how big they are. They aren't just changing the world, but being a part of our everyday life while making a rumbling effect in the tech industry and global markets as well. Originally known as Advanced Semiconductor Materials Lithography, the Dutch multinational corporation ASML is the world's largest supplier in the semiconductor industry, and the sole supplier of extreme ultraviolet lithography photolithography machines. Of what use are EUV versus? EUV lithography is used to manufacture the most advanced chips around the world. The size of a city bus, EUV versus employ tiny beams of light to carve patterns on the silicon components that make semiconductor chips. The company's superiority in this sector is now unrivaled. ASML says that their most advanced technology is so complicated that replicating it would take at least 15 years. Thanks to the gamble, ASML took a risk in the 1990s by pursuing the development of EUV technology. Several of the companies that were seen as its competitors decided not to take the risk of investing in EUV in the 1990s, as it seemed so complicated, would burn a lot of cash, and possibly never work. But not ASML. The shift to EUV was truly long and expensive. The company had to encourage its clients, including Intel, Samsung, and Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, to acquire stock in the company so that it could fund its research. And by the time they launched their first commercial EUV machines in 2017, it was a huge industrial success that led the company to be a trailblazer in its industry. The process had cost $9 billion for 15 years, but the payoff was huge. The company had sold 125 EUV machines as of September 2021, which may not sound like much, but ASML sells them for more than $100 million apiece. Because there aren't many businesses capable of producing the most advanced form of chips using this equipment, ASML has a monopoly in its industry. And with a 2022 valuation of $200 billion, ASML is the most highly valued European tech company by market capitalization in the world today. We bet this move makes you recall any step you have taken that has been a long and arduous process. And if it doesn't, what steps are you taking today to be a major player in your field? How important are semiconductors and their market today? Or maybe the question should be, how important do you think they are? Described as the brains of modern electronics, the market's growth has been quickly attributed to the increasing consumption of consumer electronics devices in everyday life across the globe. With the advancement and the ever-increasing economic and technological importance of semiconductors in the world today, the global market size of semiconductors was at $527 billion in 2021, with a projection of $1,380 billion in 2029. An integral component of electronic devices that enables diverse advances in our communication, computing, healthcare, transportation, clean energy and military systems. It is quite easy to see the need to control and adequately regulate the use of semiconductors in their markets, data and system. Following the US-China trade war, the US Commerce Department, in October 2022, issued a comprehensive set of prohibitions on exports to China of semiconductor chips and other high-tech equipment. The ban is said to be one of the most important policy moves of the year, marking a significant shift in the Biden administration's strategy towards China while posing a substantial threat to high-tech industries in China, including its military technology and artificial intelligence advancements. Biden, in a bid to prevent China from buying and gaining access to the world's best chips and machines, aims to stifle the growth of ever-growing technological advancement in the Chinese tech industry. Most importantly, prevent them from making these chips by themselves, for their personal use and that of the major market. China began its semiconductor journey in the 1990s, first focusing on integrated circuit design. China has emerged as a prominent participant in the field after a 30-year journey, accounting for about 13% of the global IC design industry in 2020. Despite the ongoing trade and technological confrontation with the United States, China has accelerated the building of domestic fabrication factories in order to localize the most critical pieces of the technology supply chain. According to the Wall Street Journal, Trump's national security advisor at the time, Charles Kupperman, informed Dutch officials in 2019 that ASML machines would not operate without American components and that the White House had the right to limit the shipment of such parts to the Netherlands. ASML's EUV machines use SMR lasers, which are manufactured in San Diego. ASML had been restricted earlier in 2019 in its homeland by the Dutch government. This restriction was on shipping its best machines to China, a decision largely influenced by the United States. However, ASML's restrictions in the Netherlands prevented it from selling its costlier chip and materials, such as EUV, to China. It may still sell its lesser semiconductor products, such as EUVs, to China. In 2021, somewhat older devices accounted for 16% of total sales in China. The sales figure from the previous year meant China was the third largest for ASML, after Taiwan and South Korea. The writings on the wall were clear as it signaled a big blow for the company in the major market. China's 16% share of ASML sales in 2021 was valued at a stunning 2.1 billion euros. A Semiconductor Industry Association and Boston Consulting Group research issued in April 2021 cautioned that export restrictions had pushed China to build its own alternative chip equipment producers. Shanghai Microelectronics Equipment is one company positioned as Beijing's alternative to ASML. ASML CEO Peter Wennink expressed fear in an interview with Politico that in 15 years' time, they'll be able to do it all by themselves, and their market would be gone. However, ASML's chief financial officer, Roger Dassin, believes that even if the company is locked out of one part of the world, the other portion of the world still requires chips. At ASML, we don't really care what chips are created as long as they're available, he explains. But with the loss of a major player, the Dutch company still maintains its sales and marketing figures. Why is that so? It all begins with a boom. Yes, a boom. ASML had an enormous boom in demand. After the pandemic, the world saw a boom in demand for semiconductors. The pandemic left ASML in an enviable position, fielding a rush of orders for new equipment. CEO Peter Wennink said in a statement that the company continues to see the demand for its system and famously quoted, "Our demand is higher than our current production capacity." The rise in demand meant they needed to increase production, putting ASML in a very good position even before the United States put a restriction on China. Peter Wennink revealed to investors that ASML was running at maximum capacity, with virtually every customer ASML had ever dealt with currently looking to buy new equipment. Lithography giant reports sustained high demand, including for its next generation of extreme ultraviolet tools. While most markets and economies were recovering from the US-China trade wars and the ravaging pandemic, there was a need to expand and increase production capacity as quickly as possible after the pandemic. In light of their demands, ASML made plans to increase its production capacity as it expected to revisit these same scenarios in the years to come to increase its growth opportunities beyond. Net bookings in the first quarter were 6.98 billion euros, down fractionally from the previous quarter. The gross margin also fell slightly due to higher input costs, but 49% was in line with the company's previous guidance. While China tries to wrap its head around sourcing and creating alternatives that could match up with the EUV or surpass it, the increase in demand has meant there is no slowing down for the tech giant, even after losing 16% of its market. The company looks forward to the feasibility of raising annual shipments of current EUV tools on the roadmap to 2025. Annual shipments of deep UV tools, which are not nearly as complex as EUV machines, could rise to 600 over the same period. Plans were all made before the restriction. ASML's chief financial officer, Roger Dassin, says there has been progress not just on the technical side, but the commercial progress has been really good on a high. Would China be able to bounce back and rival not just the US but ASML with its technology, or would ASML remain a dominant force in its industry? Let us know in the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications, so you don't miss our other videos.